So I made speaker stickers because I was sick of always needing to, you know, take my phone out of my pocket every time I wanted to find something out about a speaker, whether it's the coverage angle or how much power is going to draw. So I made these little speakers that you can put on the back of any speaker. And they are 2 by 3 inches because I feel like that is probably as big as it can get before it starts running out of space and covering up controllers and knobs and things like that. Self-adhesive. The only thing you can really write on these with is a Sharpie. So I tried a Sharpie pen, that doesn't work. I tried a ballpoint pen, that doesn't work. I tried a another Sharpie pen, that doesn't work. The only thing that works is a Sharpie marker, okay? But it works great, no problem. Just make sure it's kind of a fine tip, you know, not one of the bigger ones, fine tip so that you can write, because you're gonna need to write kind of small on here. Let's talk about how to fill these out. So over on the speaker stickers sales page, there's also a little calculator here that's gonna help you. So I'm gonna leave that open. I've got a speaker sticker open here. Now the first thing is the name. Why is there such a big space for the name? Well, a lot of you are just going to write, you know, the model of the speaker, but I was inspired by Springer Opera House. Springer Opera House is the first company that I went on a national theatrical tour with when I moved back to the United States from living in Europe. And one of the coolest things that they did was that on every one of their Boston truck tours that they went on, everything that went in the truck, every piece of equipment had a unique, fun name. So for example, the little Behringer controller that I had in the little box wasn't called the Behringer controller model number XYZ, it was called Beaker. And that was because everyone on the show was doing double duty. So all of the actors helped us load in and load out, for example. So they would get done with the show, shake everyone's hand in the audience, and then help us break down and load out. Because of that, we needed easy names to remember so that people didn't have to figure out the UPA, 1P, something. So what does that mean, these random letters and numbers? No, it was the Beaker, okay? So you might want to call your speaker the UPA 1P or whatever the model is, or you might want to call it Nate or Beaker or something fun like that. Anyway, that's the reason for the space up there. Let's talk about how to fill out the rest of this. So you notice I have vertical and horizontal angle. I think the next time I get these printed, I'll do it the other way around because it keeps confusing me. I should have done horizontal and then vertical. Anyway, how do we find out the vertical coverage angle of our speaker? Well, we open up the specification sheet, the data sheet. So here are the specifications for UPA 1P. I way zoomed in so you can see it. And we look at coverage, we look at vertical, and it says 40 degrees. 40 degrees. What is the order? This is where the calculator is going to start helping you. So this was set at 0, but there we go. That breaks it. So then we put in 40, and that tells us, hey, that's a second order speaker. The forward aspect ratio is 2.92, and the lateral aspect ratio is 0.68. Cool, let's do the same thing for the horizontal angle. Take a look at the data sheet, 100 degrees. Put that into the calculator. So that is a first order speaker. 1.31 is the forward aspect ratio, and 1.53 is the lateral aspect ratio. Let's take a look at the power. So I'm not an expert on power, but the main questions that I have when hooking stuff up are, how many of these can I put on a circuit? I don't want to get in trouble. I'm looking at AC power down here. There's a lot of options, but I'm basically looking for the biggest number. So I'm looking for the peak current draw. And here I see that it is 5 amps at 115 volts. I'm in the US, so I'm normally running on 115 volts. So that's what I'm gonna write on here. And I'm gonna make a note to myself that that's 5 amps peak. And I could even, I guess, write more numbers on there about these other options, burst current, continuous current, current draw, idle, stuff like that. But I'm going to say 5 amps at 115 volts. And once I know those two pieces of information, then the calculator is going to tell me that is 575 volts. So range, what does that mean? Well, that's operating range. So I'll scroll back up. I'll find operating range. See that it's 60 hertz to 18 kilohertz. Peak SPL, that's right over here, 133 dB. Okay, what is the class? I'll put 133 in the calculator, and I see that's class 3. What is the crossover? 1200 hertz. So that one is 16 ohm, 100 watts. So I'll just write 16, 100, and then the low frequency driver is 2 and 400. And I'm done. So I'd be writing this out by hand. I would pull it off the back of the paper and slap it on the speaker and do the next one. So those are speaker stickers. Let me know if any of this was confusing for you or what questions it brought up for you. And also let me know if you have any suggestions. Maybe you saw something that I'm doing wrong. Maybe you know some ways that I could improve these stickers. All right, thanks.